Sprint presents Lie Detector. Kyle and Audrey have been hooked up to a lie detector. Let's see who's telling the truth and who's lying.
I have iPhone Forever from Sprint, so I never have to wait to get the newest iPhone.
I don't have iPhone Forever from Sprint, so it's 15 months until I can upgrade to the new iPhone 6S. But I don't mind waiting. And I'm not jealous of your new iPhone either. Honestly, I'm not lying.
Get the fire extinguisher!
On second thought, can I just switch to Sprint?
The world's best offer on iPhone 6S. Get iPhone 6S as low as $1 a month when you trade in your iPhone 6. And with iPhone Forever, get a new iPhone every year forever.
Offer not available everywhere. Includes 21-month lease, no security deposit. Excludes taxes, subject to well-qualified credit. New line port at $36 activation fee. Requires smartphone trade-in. Regular $22 a month. iPhone Forever's lease upgrade eligibility does not guarantee monthly payment amount, phone selection, or plan rates. Service is additional charge. Remaining lease payments due if service canceled. Restrictions apply. See Sprint.com.
Yo, you know what time it is, man. Time for the Live is Cloud Radio Show on the planet, man. Straight from the E-Block. Live on your dial every Friday, man, 6 to 7 p.m. My nigga City Shaw bringing in all the way from Texas, boy. What up, dog?
City in my hand, block on my back. Got a doing for my hood, cause you know it's brown, man. Anywhere a nigga go, I stay rapping my town. Detroit be the city where it all goes down. City in my hand, block on my back. Got a doing for my hood, cause you know it's brown, man. Anywhere a nigga go, I stay rapping my town. Detroit be the city where it all goes down. I gotta do it for my city, rep the hood I'm in. City is a struggle to make it, but we gon' get it in. East side where I'm at, that's where a nigga stay. I know you see me on my grind, gotta make a way. I see the news, read the papers, what we going through. Hear these niggas talking shit, talking down on what we do. But everything you see I do it for my city. From the hood to the block, everybody feel me. You see, that's all a nigga know, I came up from that. I gotta do it for my niggas, ain't no turning back. It's been like this from the start, ain't no easy way. See, it's a struggle to make it, we hustle 7 days. Ain't no vacation, my nigga gotta ride it out. Just spend a day in my city, see what I'm talking about. Cause where I'm from, I'm used to seeing niggas giving up. Pressure on my back from day one, but never gave it up. City in my hand, block on my back. Gotta do it for my hood, cause you know it's where I'm at. Anywhere a nigga go, I stay reppin' my town. Detroit be the city where it all goes down. City in my hand, block on my back. Gotta do it for my hood, cause you know it's where I'm at. Anywhere a nigga go, I stay reppin' my town. Detroit be the city where it all goes down. Riding through my city got me thinking about them block days. Struggle just to make it, my nigga, but always made a way. Seeing my nigga put away, getting locked up. Got niggas thinking so before a nigga got it fucked up. See, I was grinding hard, now I'm about to grind harder. We made it for my nigga, now I'm about to make it public. Put that on my hood, give me a couple of years. See the whole life and do it all, we shed no tears. Thinking about the past, wishing I could press rewind. It's hard coming where I'm from, all I know is why I know. It's been like this from the start, back against the wall. Niggas hate to see us shine, only wanna see us fall. I'm being where I'm from, niggas struggle every day. So I can relate, so niggas feel what I say. But ain't no holding me back until I make it on. I gotta do it for Detroit, so I'ma carry on. City in my hand, block on my back. Gotta do it for my hood, cause you know it's where I'm at. Anywhere a nigga go, I stay reppin' my town. Detroit be the city where it all goes down. City in my hand, block on my back. Gotta do it for my hood, cause you know it's where I'm at. Anywhere a nigga go, I stay reppin' my town. Detroit be the city where it all goes down.
Wait, Oval is that?
Yo, you know what time it is, man. We back. Top of the Live is Car Radio Show on the planet, man. Straight from the E-Block Live on your dial. Every Friday, 6 to 7 p.m. My man just finally made it in here, dog. My man, Money holding it down.
I'm here,
you know what I'm saying? Finally, you know, CP time. Got my man Big Win in the building. You gotta say something, though. You can say something. I got my man Corbin Cody. He's not gonna. I was gonna say he ain't gonna be on camera.
We on camera.
It's Corbin Cody.
What up, boy?
Why you always say it backwards, though? It's my money, bro. It's my money.
This is how it says on your Twitter page.
Yes, it does. Real monk money. Yes.
I thought it was Instagram.
Same.
It is?
Yeah, same.
What about your Snapchat?
I don't do no Snapchat.
E-Block Radio does have a Snapchat.
It does. I know.
Just started maybe about a week ago. So shout out to E-Block Radio on Snapchat.
Anything positive in the community so we can whip.
He don't understand that. He just gonna whip. Don't let that. Don't let that.
Don't let that.
That's what's up, man. I want to welcome everybody back, man. It's been a long week, of course. Don't forget, man, if you're on social media, you got to hit us up, dog. Hit us up on Instagram, my man, Real Monk Money. Also, myself, Hood, Howard Stern. Same thing on Twitter. So if you're on Twitter, if you're on Instagram, dog, make sure you hit us up. I will not touch the edibles today at this point in time. But anyway, man, I want to welcome everybody back, dog. It's been a long week, dog, so we always go around the block to see what's going on. I got the guests in the studio. I don't know if they want to talk, you know what I'm saying? It's a big win. We ain't seen you in years, but you only got a couple minutes, so you can't be talking about your whole life story, but introduce yourself to the people, man.
Where you been, nigga? Oh, man, I moved, I lived everywhere, man. Georgia, Iowa, I'm all over the place, man.
That's what's up, man.
E-Block Radio, no matter where it is, man.
For sure, all day, every day.
700 miles, it don't matter. It's right with me.
700 miles.
Yeah,
can't
get Hey, don't get it twisted, man. No, that's a live radio show, man. Never find anything else.
Original.
You can't Google it. I have the app.
You can get out of the
app. Download the app. You can not without a solo cup. You gotta get a solo cup first when you download the app. Come on, man.
Yeah.
For real now.
What's up with you, dog?
Gotta get a solo.
Solo.
Yeah,
solo
cup.
Red
cup.
Come on, dog. Come on, man.
I like big glasses like normal.
From glasses. My bad.
My guy always, Corporate Cody, always act like he clueless. I didn't know that what they do is, I can't even say
that. No, man.
Just for the record, though, Corbin Cody from Chalmers, so don't even fuck it up.
Support. Listen, man.
For sure, man.
That's real.
My money, what's been up with you, bro?
Same old shit with your boy, dog.
It's a fly new polo, though.
That is, man.
That's always good.
I don't do my time, you know what I'm saying?
Fuck around and get a second job.
That's what I'm end up doing, man. I got a second job at Bluefin, man.
Oh, you already did?
Sushi bar, man.
Come oh, damn.
I'm learning sushi. My money doing everything. You know what I'm talking about? I'm learning sushi, baby.
What the hell is a sushi face? I don't know. That's what happens when you have guests in the studio.
Make some up a lady sushi face for the ladies.
That's probably who the sushi face is for.
Hey, but anyway. back to the task at hand.
Right.
I'm nuzzling on these things I got on playing poker. Well, I'm talking about money, but I got some good out of it. You know what I'm saying? I got this one having a nice-ass cookie.
So it's not a regular cookie?
No, it's not a regular cookie. It's a regular cookie to regular people.
But you're not regular.
No, I'm not regular.
That's the sound I feel, man.
I'm on another planet right now. You know what I'm talking about?
I can probably tell. Like, I want to get a piece, man, but I don't want to fuck up all my vocabulary.
Man,
so,
I'm
away.
I'm
going to get some in a minute, though. When we go to the pregame mix, you know? The pregame mix, though, that I did myself.
What?
I got a DJ application.
Hey, just
I got. I didn't say let's go on the shit. All
right, okay.
They got pissed last week. I just kept saying let's go, like with the little ad libs and shit. I did that, but my whole thing though is that I did it on this one though. DJ 2, the application and shit. I did my thing.
Let's go, my nigga.
You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get burst out, huh? So pregame mix on me today, man. Shout out to everybody. You know, the two people that did contribute and shit. You know what I'm saying? Two people that did contribute, shout out to y'all, but I'm going to go ahead and take over the shit from here. I'm going to go ahead and do my thing. All right, so I did that. But anyway, what else been going on with you, dog, before I get to myself?
Oh, man, that's been up with you, boy. That's it with you, boy. You know what I'm saying?
You know,
I keep it low to the ground like an ant, you know what I mean? But
speaking of low to the flow like an ant, though, my man's never say that Ant-Man was good, dog.
It was good.
I slept on it.
Dog, I saw the preview.
And I was like, I didn't want to see that shit.
I said, I wanted to see
it. Oh, you did want to see it?
Because I was actually at the movies and shit when the previews popped up. I'm like, damn.
Oh, originally. Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So I wanted to see Ant-Man, bro. Like,
that shit is
good. Check it out, man.
Yeah.
Yo, go see it, man.
Yeah.
And
tomorrow we'll
give
us
some sponsorship. There you go.
Right. And Polo, too, man. We'll give y'all out of this.
Yeah, Polo.
Holler at us. Probably be hollering at Rob Lauren right here. See what we can do about that. Anything else going on, man? You see any movies this week?
No, man. I have Insidious 3, and I want to see that, bro. You know what I mean? Because 1 and 2 is really, really decent.
I haven't seen
no scary movies that was really, really decent in a long time, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And this one, 1 and 2.
Really, really decent.
Yeah, really decent.
Okay. I'll actually consider it.
Like this for me, like, damn.
Yeah, it's on Netflix.
No.
Oh, 3 is new. I forgot. My bad. Yeah. Bootleg King. In the house.
Excuse me, I don't do like anything.
I know you don't. You just partake in it. Anyway.
Yeah.
So, what else is going on, though?
Nothing else, dog. What's the problem with you?
Yeah, me and myself, man, we will get off the bootleg situation because I know government officials may be watching. But me and myself, dog, not been doing too much of nothing, dog. Just trying to get ready for this move to Denver, you know, this relocation. Still haven't got an exact date on that
Everybody's
yet, so we still.
What?
Oh, look, you know what the motherfucker told
like
me?
A bitch.
He said he only see me during the show anyway, so it don't even matter. But definitely the show must go on, so obviously we still go do the show. The times may change, of course, so we'll be in a different time zone, but we go figure that out. But we always keep that coming for you. But this past week, man, not really much of nothing. I did watch that movie, though, that City Shy was talking about last week. Remember Me?
Yeah.
Y'all, the shit was good. Y'all ever heard of that?
Remember Me?
Yeah, probably about a year ago. My man, what's the dude's name? The dude, Twilight, the man character, look like he dead and shit. What's that motherfucker's name? Pattinson.
Yeah.
Why do you look like he dead?
I don't know.
Don't he like a vampire or some shit?
He looks like a vampire.
He like a fucking vampire, but.
He
fucking look like a vampire. Remember Me, dog. The shit was good, though. The shit was about a dude. First it was two different people really. The first chick, her mom's got killed on the subway and shit, and then dude had like his older brother killed himself when he was probably like 21 or 22. But anyway, the main thing really is my man, what was it, Robert Pattinson, whatever the name is. But him and his old man had a badass relationship, like they couldn't get the shit together. His old man was a lawyer, he was a fuck up. So you know if they were one of them kind of things, like they just kept butting heads. So at the end, they finally got the shit together. You know what I'm saying? The old man and shit really started trying to connect with his kids because he had kind of lost connection with the kids after the one son killed himself. So that's where they kind of lost connection. But at the end, he started really trying to get that shit together. Fucked up thing though. At the end of shit, they finally pulled it together. He told him to meet him at his office. At that point, he was working at the Twin Towers and shit. It was motherfucking 9/11. Yeah. But he was like. He was mending a relationship, so he was late because he was taking the daughter to school, some shit that he hadn't done in years. So he's like, you know, I'm gonna take your sister to school and meet me at the office. He went to the office, motherfucking plane blew that bitch up, and he never got a chance to see his son. Fucked up. She was kind of good though.
Yeah.
Like it was really good, and like it never gave you a clue that it was anything about 9/11. It never gave you a clue until the end. So then he was standing at the window and shit, looking out, like waiting on his old man. Like the crazy thing was, he thought his old man didn't fuck with him, period. But when he went in his office, his screensaver was all his kids and shit. He was like, damn, he really do fuck with us. He just don't know how to.
Love us.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Love.
Right. But he like, he really just didn't know it. So he like that. So he went and stood up at the window. He was just looking outside like, damn, I can't wait till you get here. Then they showed the little girl after she got dropped off at school and she was fucking off. And the teacher was like, you know, said something to her. And she's like, pay attention, you know what I'm saying? But when she walked away from the board, the date was written on the board. I was like, aw, damn, that's fucked up. That shit was good, though, man.
Damn, hey, look, you just told the whole fucking movie, though.
I did.
So you don't need to see
it. Hey, but on that tip, though, real quick, though, before we jump.
Song Girl, that was good, too.
I never seen that either. It was good.
Yeah,
it was critically acclaimed and shit. It better
have won an Emmy Award.
Exactly.
Academy Award for it.
Yeah, Academy Award. Now, before we jump off into the pregame mix and shit, of course, you know what I'm saying? Then we got my man Writer's Block G. That's my man Buns. Rest in peace, man. That's his little brother and shit. We're going to play his joint at the end of the show today. But before we jump off into that and into the title for today, I just want to kind of reflect on that real quick while we all sitting here talking about that movie. Dog, do y'all remember that shit, though?
Yeah,
like,
9-11?
9-11. Dog, I'm saying, like, what was y'all doing at that point? Like, big man, what was you doing?
Man, I just got out of I was in class.
They actually had the old school
TV with the VCR. Yeah. In the dorm, and it was going down. Like, there was nothing about it, you know.
Yeah, that shit was crazy.
It was crazy.
No, you remember that shit?
Yeah, we was at school. I was at the Maryland, matter of fact. I had a break in between classes. So I went to do some stuff for football, and then the head coach actually called me in his office. It was like, be a pivotal moment in your generation's timeline in history.
Hell yeah.
I was like, what are you talking? Because I was near no TV. I didn't know what he was talking. I was in the weight room.
Where was you at?
In the weight room. But I know he told me it's a pivotal point in our timeline as far as history for our generation. What are you talking about? I'm in his office. I was like, whoa. And then my brother, he was coming from London though, at that time. He was overseas at the Air Force. They had to land most planes in Canada. So we had to wait 3 more days before he came home.
Yeah.
So they stopped all transport. It come anywhere around New York, around East Coast.
Any borders, period.
Yeah. They had to go to Canada. We had to wait 3 or 4 days for him to come home.
Yeah.
So, it was crazy.
Yes, it was crazy.
I think we still had to play that weekend at the football
team. Yeah, it did.
We still played there with some college teams. We banded together just to show our support for America. We played there.
Uh-huh. And practice actually got canceled.
Yeah, practice got canceled.
Yeah, practice did. But classes didn't. Yeah. Classes didn't, though. Money, what you say, man?
Man, I was at work, bro. You know what I'm saying? And they stopped production at work so everybody can watch it.
Exactly,
So, I mean, it was kind of crazy, bro, that they actually did that, though. I've been working in the business.
Right, what else, though? Sitting inside in the building? We got nothing left to put this shit in now. Gotta go back to the stove. But yeah, myself, man, shit, low-key that morning, man, it was crazy because Tuesday, it was a Tuesday morning and shit, and I remember it was Tuesday because Tuesday was the day that I actually did the school newspaper. So I was actually sending the newspaper off, and the dude came through, this white dude, I can't remember his name, but he was a veteran, he came through, he's like, dude, like, they like blowing up the Pentagon or some shit. I'm like, dog, what you talking about? He's like, dude, you ain't saying that, because he was talking about the Pentagon shit. So all of that shit happened at one time, like, you know, they blew up the towers, then they sent the plane at the Pentagon, but they blew that motherfucker up before it got there. We're talking about the movie at first, now we're talking about like for real, like in real life. So my man telling me that shit, I'm like, dude, what you talking about? So we hit the matter of fact, I got the radio on because there wasn't even a TV in there. So I mean, at that point, we listening to that shit, and then I'm watching them. So we went into one of the teachers' room, like you said, that rolled out the TV with the VCR. Mm-hmm. So we watching that shit. And I seen the second one come through. You know what I'm saying? The second one that tore up the second tower. Now, the crazy thing is, though, is that I was watching the replay. But I can't even imagine, though, because, you know, this shit was getting reported already when the first one got ran into. So he reported when the second one came through. So a lot of niggas seen that shit live. I didn't see that shit live. I mean, yeah, you can put it in the cool. But I'm just like, dog, that shit was crazy because, like, you just got to imagine you sitting there, you watching TV. What up, though? So you sitting there watching TV, and they reporting like, damn, you know what I'm saying? It ran into the first one and sitting there while he reporting, the second one get took out. Like, dog, that shit's amazing. That shit was crazy, man. Like you mentioned earlier, that was a pivotal part in our history, man. So that's why I think that movie was good to sell. So I got to thank City Shop for that one, man. That movie was good to see.
That shit was good,
you know what I'm saying? And it make you reflect, you know, back on that shit because real talk, man, that was the same year, nigga. That's when I was out at Black Enterprise working the shit. That shit happened September 11th. I had just left in August, like a few weeks before that. You know what I'm saying? I had just left. And the building was not too far from the Twin Towers. Like, just I could have been stuck in New York. You know what I'm saying? I was just out there living in Manhattan and all that shit.
DT, I believe.
Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying.
They were shutting everything down.
They were shutting everything down. Like I say, I was just out there, you know what I'm saying, in Manhattan and shit, doing my thing at Black Enterprise Shop. But, yeah, man, that shit was crazy. The movie was good, though, man, so I got to give you a shout out on that, though. So make sure you check that out. But real quick, though, before we jump into our topic, man, of course, we got to do the pregame mix, man. Y'all was here. Y'all was too late to talk about y'all weekend because it's over now.
I do shit anyway.
Yeah, I feel you, man. Hey, but look, if you're not up on what we're talking about this week, man, we trying to talk about relationships, man. We want to know if your mate has a child outside your relationship, do you stay with that person, man? That's what we want to know. And I know.
Do you?
I mean, do you? And I posted something on Facebook this week and shit, and I think, and always, I know it's probably sexist, but I think it is different when a woman comes back with a kid outside of the relationship. I think it is different. No, we can talk about that when we get back, though. You love her? All right, man. We're going to be back in like 6 minutes, man. I got a pregame mix that I done myself, all right? I didn't do the ad-libs, though. I did do the ad-libs, all right?
I'm straight for the tonight, DJ.
Yeah, I'm a DJ, man. DJ, let's say that on there, too. Let's say DJ. I even do some scratches and shit.
Let me see.
I ain't bullshit, man. We back in like 6 minutes, dog. Hey, but look. don't forget to call us, man. 760-283-4647, man. I want to hear from y'all, though. Especially ladies. I want to hear what y'all got to say. It is a special app, though, man. DJ 2, man. We be back.
It's two revolvers, see me smoke ain't going horn. Cause the bitch ain't ever shit to me, a pussy stay selling. So I never let it get to me, the shit to me is simple. We relies on credentials, we credible individuals ahead of you, we original. Better known as criminals, thugging off on the cereal. Killing them on the radio, some of them wanna hate me though. Fuck them cause they can't see me though, and here we go again. The jealousy took you over success, just keep you slower. While you get nothing, we keep getting lower. Pump, pump the jammer, drop the top. Hit the switch, smash down the block. And over here it's Long Beach, so you know when you see a nigga. And don't ever get the wrong idea, nigga.
Yeah, nigga, what?
Holla.
Now I don't want anybody to get the wrong idea about me. I don't have nothing to hide. I want the world to see.
I'm a gangster, gangster.
Gangsta niggas do your thing.
Tilted to the east on the bitch, I remain the beast. None the least, police try to cuff me and stuff me in the back of they patrol car. Cause I'm a former parole star. What's your cool name? This nigga here's a fool, man. Gonna do your thing. Gang bang in the hood and in Hollywood. Record company executives think it's all to the good. Get to showing me around their house. Then he slide me in the back and had a nerve to try to buy me out. Check this out, man. I'm down with P and D-R-E. A real nigga from the motherfucking LBC. I just look like this. I stay down for the twist. I'm real with this. Deep as a bitch. As I gave you a pound, then I gave your wife a kiss. I had to dip because y'all was full of that bullshit.
Fundamental, no, you can't find this shit in a handbook. Take a close look at a rap crook. Rule number one, get yourself a gun. A nine in your ass will be fine. Keep it in your glove compartment, cause jackers, oh, they love to start shit. Now if you're white, you can trust the police. But if you're black, they ain't nothing but beef. Watch out for the kill. Don't make a false move and keep your hands on the steering wheel. And don't get smart, answer all questions. And that's your first lesson on staying alive. South Central, yeah. That's how you survive.
Hi, this is Amanda King. Are you enjoying your stay in South Central Los Angeles? Or is somebody taking your things? Have you witnessed a drive-by? Make sure you have your camcorder ready in case you
pot. Cause it ain't nothing but a trap. And females will get you jacked and kidnapped. You wind up dead. Just to be safe, don't wear no blue or red. Cause most niggas get got. In either L.A., Compton, or Watts. Pissed off black human beings. So I think you better skip the sightseeing. And if you're nothing but a mark, make sure that you're in before dark. But if you need some affection, mate, make sure the bitch ain't a section 8. Cause if so, that's a monkey wrench hoe. And you won't survive in South Central.
Now you realize it's not always cracked up to be. You realize that it's fucked up. I mean, nothing like the shit you saw on TV. Palm trees and palm bitches. So I advise you to pack your shit and get the fuck on. Yeah.
Bailed outside and pointed my weapon. Just as I thought, the fools kept stepping. Jumped in the foe, hit the juice on my ride. I got front and back and side to side. Then I let the Alpine play. Bumping new shit, buying WA. It was gangsta at the top of the list. Then I played my old shit, it went something like this. Cruising down the street in my 6'4". Jocking the bitches, slapping the hoes. Went to the park to get the scoop. Knuckleheads out there, cold shooting some hoops. A car pulls up, who can it be? A fresh El Camino rolling Kilo G. He rolled down his window and he started to say, it's all about making that GTA. Cause the boys in the hood are always hard. They come talking that trash, we'll pull your car. Knowing nothing in life but to be legit. Don't quote me, boy, cause I ain't said shit.
Get the fuck out.
Donald B's in the place to give me the face. He said my man JD is on free base. The boy JD was a friend of mine till I got in my car trying to steal an Alpine. Chasing him up the street to call a truce. The city motherfucker pulls out a deuce deuce. Little did he know I had a loaded 12 gauge. One sucker dead, LA Times front page. Cause the boys in the hood are always hard. You come talking that trash, we'll pull your car. Knowing nothing in life but to be legit. Don't quote me, boy, cause I ain't said shit.
When something happens in South Central Los Angeles, nothing happens. It's just another nigga dead, 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 dead.
Straight out of Compton, crazy motherfucker named Ice Cube. From the gang called Niggas with Attitudes. When I'm called off, I got a sawed off. Squeeze the trigger and bodies are hauled off. You too, boy, if you fuck with me. The police are gonna have to come and get me. Off your ass, that's how I'm going out. For the punk motherfuckers that's showing out. Niggas start to mumble.
The building, dog. You know what I'm talking about? I just fucked up again. I hit the stop recording, man. I wasn't supposed to do that that time, man. It's the same thing happened last time. I know, dog. Hey, but we back in the building, man. Thank y'all for checking us out, dog. You know what that was, dog. That's the pregame mix. Very first one done by your boy, man, the Hood Hour Star. We in the building, man. Got my homie Big Win all the way from Iowa City.
Iowa.
You know what I'm talking about? Got my man, City finally made it in with the ice.
Yeah, man, with the ice and all this type of stuff.
You know what I'm saying? Got my man Money holding it down as always.
For sure. I
didn't
know they had niggas in Iowa, though.
No, they got niggas in Iowa. They about to have niggas in Colorado. You
that's
feel me?
Up.
And, of course, man, your boy, man, the Hood Howard Stern holding it down in the place to be, man. We back in the building, dog. We got, like, 30 minutes left, so we got to hit on to that hot topic.
So if you've been following us on Instagram, follow us on Twitter, you already know what we're talking about, man. We're talking about relationships. I want to know, City Shy, we're going to you first. I want to know, if your mate get pregnant outside your relationship, do you stay?
Man, hell to no. Fuck no.
Fuck no?
So, man, I don't even know why I can get into details about this, dog. Just no. Yeah,
man. Like this, just no.
Nigga, no, man.
Period.
I mean, how could you be with somebody, dog, who had a kid? Like, what we talking about? Like, we in relationship, everything going good?
Well, or whatever, you think everything good, right?
If I think everything going good, dog, hell no. Nigga, you gonna come back, nigga, you pregnant and shit. You probably think it's yours for a minute. And
right.
Come and tell you like you know it's Craig.
Right. Like, that, Craig. I think that's probably the hard part.
No, not
is
like
that you might not know if it's yours or not.
Yeah, so even if you got questions, dog, even if it come around to be mine, but you still had to question if it was mine.
Then it's still a problem.
I'm gone, dog.
Yeah, even me?
Fuck that.
Yeah.
Fuck that. I know about that whole little shit with D Wade and Grab Your Union. The little break baby and shit.
When they was on the break though.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was on the break. But I mean like you in a relationship though.
No, dog, can't even do it.
Can't do it?
Cause shit, I know if it was the vice versa, she wouldn't fuck with me.
Okay, well, we're going to touch on that in a moment, too, though.
Yeah, but no, man, she come around 3 months pregnant. Yeah, I think it's crazy. So you got to watch the build up, stomach get big, you know, it ain't yours.
Right, laying next to that motherfucker, rubbing and rubbing his stomach and shit.
She maybe kicking and shit.
Going to get
snacks.
Right, going to get the pickle and cheese and shit.
So y'all going out public, nigga, congratulations. You know you got play and shit, man. And crawl or Larry and beat your girl down.
Got Larry.
I can't do it, dog. I can't even do it.
Right, Larry. I wasn't ready for that.
Larry the plumber came over.
Larry the plumber.
Came over supposed to, you know, say fix the drain and got you knocked up.
No,
right.
He fixed the drain.
Right, all right, right.
Yeah, I can't do that.
Checking the meter.
I can't do that one, bro.
Can't do it.
Nope.
I feel you. So, Big Win, what you say, bro? You can you do it, man? Your mate had a kid outside the relationship, man. Can you stick around?
Man. You know what? No. You know what? It ain't gonna happen because of the simple fact that it's disrespect. And then on top of that, there's a whole lot of dishonesty there at the same time, though, too. Now, this is a different situation. Now, if you got with her while she was pregnant,
well, yeah, obviously,
you know
that's different.
Saying?
You made that choice.
But if you didn't know she was pregnant beforehand and then all this shit go down, I mean, it take a grown motherfucker to do that shit. Like, I mean, straight up.
Yeah.
Most motherfuckers
super grown motherfucker.
Most people wouldn't even do it.
I mean, not at all.
Me personally, I'd be like, you know what? Look, no. Good luck to you.
Right.
And we're going to move on. You know
right.
What I mean? Like, that takes a lot of heart. And it takes a lot of forgiveness. That's a lot of, you know,
that took a hell of a lot of forgiveness.
You know what I'm saying? That's not something like, you know, we preach as black people, you know what I'm saying? We go to church and forgive, but certain shit.
There's certain shit.
Like, you know what? I'm going to take the devil's in on this one, man. I ain't going to fuck with you.
Yeah, fuck
you know what I don't think I'm going to ever come up to a dude and tell him, like, in the midst of her being pregnant, that she stepped out and that's why she's pregnant. I think she's going to wait.
It's going to always happen at the end.
Yeah, I can't see her coming, especially if the relationship is, well, if he thinking it's good,
right.
And everything, y'all peaches and cream, y'all working, and everything y'all got.
You better tell me, because this is going to make the shit worse.
No, she ain't going to tell you that.
If she don't tell me through the motherfucking 9 months, and I'm thinking this motherfucker, and I'm going to get motherfucking pickles and honeycomb, and your bitch pickles and honeycomb.
And your bitch ass pregnant by another motherfucker. Okay.
That's
a crazy, shit for your ass, right,
man.
Man,
too, man.
Right.
That shit is crazy, though. You know what I'm saying? Me personally, hell, fuck no. Like, hell no. Like, if you had the audacity to walk, I might Ocho Cinco her ass. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but that motherfucker.
Bitch! Are you serious? I mean, it's just a reaction, you know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
I mean, no, that's the that is a man when say you gotta have a lot of forgiveness. No, that's some disrespect shit.
It is.
Like,
it
come
is.
On, though. You ain't even think to go get some money for the nigga and get an abortion low key and tell me you on your period for 6 weeks?
Some,
like, goddamn. You know what I'm saying? Like,
Said you gotta appear for 6 weeks.
You come to me and tell me that shit. You got a lot of balls. You know what I'm saying? Like seriously, you got a lot of balls.
Yeah.
Because I'm nutting up, bro. I might spaz out, bro.
I feel.
I mean, cause I'm thinking the relationship good too. You know what I'm saying? I'm out, motherfucker. You know, doing my thing. Oh, I'm about my baby a car for nothing. Oh, I'm gonna do this for my boo-boo. She pregnant with my baby. I'm gonna go pick up the honeycomb and pick it before she tell me to go get the motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying?
No. You know, I just want to throw this out there. Now, what if she not sure? All right, so she cheated on you, shit. Okay. What if she not sure that it's the other dude, baby? And she think that wait. And she think that it is yours. And then later on, you find out that it ain't yours. Does that make the situation different?
Fuck no, because the point you just said you cheated on me. Fuck you right there. You know what I'm saying? You said you cheated on me. I don't give a fuck what situation going on in the meanwhile, in between time. I'm still focused on the fact, bitch, you fuck another dick, enter my shit. You know what I'm saying?
I feel you.
Okay.
But you already know what I'm going to say, though.
I was
you already know what I'm going to say.
I was a fuck, bro. I wonder what you about to say. Tell him what you about to say.
Well, you already know that, is it? I mean, I agree. I agree with you wholeheartedly, but I have to also say it's a sexist opinion.
Sexist.
I mean, it is, because you know that a lot of women have stayed with dudes. You know what I'm saying? A lot of women stay with dudes who had kids outside their relationship, their marriage, or whatever. A lot of, you know what I'm saying? A lot of dudes have done that. Oh shit! What up, yo? What up, bro? What's going on, bro?
Slim back in the building.
You know what I'm saying? Live on air. You know what I'm talking about? My man Slim in the building. Yeah. But I'm just saying, like, so you know it's a little sexist, dog. You know, a lot of women have stayed with dudes who have kids outside they married and they relationship. Now I just say that only because I'm just gonna do a side note real quick. I'm gonna let you get your point. All right, so I watched Cadillac Records. I ain't never watched Cadillac Records.
That was a shit movie.
But I remember Gabrielle Union was sitting on the side of the bed and she had a baby to handle. Man, I was like, nigga, who the fuck baby is that? She was like, somebody dropped the motherfucker off, said she can't take care of it no more. It's your baby, right? So I'm just thinking, like, damn, women do shit like that, though. Women take care of your motherfucking side bitch kids and all that shit. But I know when it comes to us, it's like she played off. Fuck that shit, man. But it is sexist, though. You have to say that. It is sexist.
I mean,
but dudes are always sexist when it comes to dudes and women.
Yeah, it's sexist. That's what I'm saying. If you come out of pussy with a dick, you're going to be somewhat sexist. You know what I'm saying? And like, seriously, bro. Like, for real, though. I mean, I might be a little bit over sexist. I might be
over sexist.
Yeah, a little bit.
Over
sexist. You know what I'm saying?
Have you ever seen? Yeah. You know, you're going to pump your son up. You find out he gets his little ass.
Yeah.
Happy.
Yeah,
you know, you find out he hit, nigga. You about to die. Somebody
about to die.
Somebody died.
You know what I'm saying? No situation like that, bro. I mean, man, hell no, bro. Like, seriously, bro.
I mean, I'm agreeing with you. I can't do it either. I mean, shit, your chick come up pregnant and it ain't yours and shit. Definitely, I can't do it. But I'm just saying, I'm just recognizing that there is.
Always happens. It is a lot of times that you fuck around your girl and then you want to have a kid and she wants to accept them.
Right.
I mean, females is built different than dudes anyway.
Yeah, I agree.
You can't lie. Females is more into relationship than dudes off real.
Off real.
You know what I'm saying? Because a girl come out the womb wanting that green wedding and everything.
All that shit, right?
Dude is trying to smash as much pussy as he can.
I'm going to tell you.
You
had a perfect woman at the crib, dude.
And still.
That shit of fucking another chick is going to be on your mind constantly.
Hey, dog, I'm going to give y'all a prime example, bro. You ever been to a wedding? And when they say the motherfucking ladies come up and catch the motherfucking bouquet, they fighting for that motherfucker. You know what I'm talking about? The niggas. They watch that bitch go all the way to the ring. You know what I'm saying? And that's just a prime example of how different the motherfucking situation is.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? And ain't no lie, some dudes need a little pressure. Some dudes want to do it, but shit.
They need that pressure.
They need that little push, you know what I'm saying? And some dudes like, nigga, fuck you, I am not doing it.
I ain't doing that shit. Yeah. Slim, what did you say, man? You say your girl come back pregnant? You keep her?
I'm a
Catholic,
okay, with the woman.
At least admit it, you know what I mean?
I'm gonna give it to her and say, hey, baby, it's our first date.
No, real talk though, man. If your girl that you with, man, she come back pregnant and it ain't yours, you stay with her? Or not?
I mean, it's
But it is what it is. I mean, I feel that. Would you consider staying in a relationship with it?
The relationship changes. You know, you got a kid with somebody else, the relationship changes. The dynamics change. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's a relationship, dog.
Thank you. It's a relationship. Yeah.
Right, what you want to get a lot of y'all? You get that word like years later?
Maybe.
If I get over it, you know what I'm saying? Because she can do some shit out the way, you know what I'm saying? That made me say, damn, I love her. Well, after years later, because I'm not going to be there when she's pregnant, and I'm not going to get pickles and fucking honeycombs. And that ain't all
so, honeycomb.
Right, I don't know. Just
bringing that up, man. That's all some traumatic shit at Walmart right there.
I never go get pickles and motherfucking honeycomb for a kid that's not mine. You know what I'm saying? I love the kids. Don't get twisted. I love playing with children. You know, I got a couple children, my goddamn self. And probably long in the long run, when they get five and get a personality, I'll probably end up liking a little nigga. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But until that nigga get the personality, until I get over the shit, bitch, you better not come my way. You feel right. me? The first year, I better not even see you or talk to you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, first year.
Shit. Uh-huh. I'm not even playing. Yeah. You might just text me out of the blue, like, how you doing? And that's how it's supposed to be for the fucking year.
Yeah.
I don't think your relationship before it began, though. Think about it, like, you broke that trust. Female or male, it's going to take a long time to
mend that shit.
Hey, you know, it's going to be on the back of your mind regardless. Yeah, one of your best friends, it's the same way.
Yeah, nigga, you can forgive, but forgetting is harder than a motherfucker.
Yeah, right? Now, if it's growing right in your eyes,
yeah. Does it make a difference if you married? So yeah. What do you do? Because if you marry, you already got your own set of kids, and then it's an extra kid. Like
this Saturday.
Nope. She ain't gonna make it.
She ain't gonna make it.
What if it was, if we go back to what I said, if it was during the time that y'all had like a little break, then she was like, shit, she fucked around, got pregnant.
That's what it is. That's what it is.
Would you get back into it though? Maybe. Because who knows if she was doing that? Who knows what the fuck I was doing?
But still, it's gonna be that time period. And the reason I say that though is because even if we got a break or whatever, and she got a kid, and she's still that time period. Yeah. Because in that time, even while the baby young and shit, baby there is still right there. Even if he ain't shit, she's still kind of connected to that motherfucker. So you gotta get that shit some time to see what it's gonna be. But I'm not about to come in and be stepdaddy and shit.
Right.
Right, and I ain't got no kid, right? So I ain't doing that shit. So no, we still gonna have to. It's still gonna be some time there. You know what I'm saying? So I think it's a little different there, but it's maybe a little more probable, maybe that we could do something. Shit, we was on a break and that shit happened.
Yeah, break up,
I was involved in a break, and then I got my girl fucked somebody else, nigga, in between the break.
Yeah.
Quotes.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
But you were on a break though, so you can be halfway mad, but not all the way mad.
I'm all the way mad. She told me not to fuck with no females. My dumb ass believed it.
Well, yeah, of course she told you that.
Damn. Man, you gonna listen? Hey, I thought we was on the same page then, you know what I'm saying? Went to the crib, seen Craig text, like, yeah. Coming through at night.
Dude, what was you saying? Luther?
Larry Plummer.
Right, sports coach.
Sports coach.
Maintenance man.
It's a week.
When the motherfucker said break. 9 times out of 10, it's another motherfucker waiting in the wing.
Women have backup.
I'm talking about because the dude can say that, and we might not necessarily. We just need a break from the motherfucking madness.
Okay. And in that break, what do you think is going to happen?
You take the other
you know, you go to work, get your money together.
Like I said.
Play mad and shit. Play mad and smoke weed. Right, it's a break.
You're going to try to see somebody else can make you stop thinking about her, though. And you're not going to stop thinking about her because you're going to be thinking what she doing on this so-called break.
Yeah.
And you're right though. It do happen a lot with dudes. Dog.
When you 22,
back in the day,
when you 36 though, you just need a fucking break.
But if you see back in the day, there's a lot of break babies though, or a lot of cheating babies or whatever. Because I know one girl, you know what I'm saying, punk ass girl. But you know, okay, she was born in the middle of that dog. Her dad was married,
uh-huh.
And shit had baby outside the marriage.
Yeah.
But you know what I'm saying, I'm seeing they still together, so they worked it out. But like, yeah. But you never see dudes forgiving a woman. That never happened.
But no. I'm gonna say I think this is why though, and I think we mentioned this on another show. And I know a lot of women hated that shit when I said it. But the reality of it is that when a woman cheat and come back with a baby, you have to deal with it.
Yes.
And I'm not taking nothing away from, you know, a dude cheating on his wife or his woman or whatever, having a baby. But the real life thing about it is that I can step outside the relationship, have a baby and shit, and I can take care of that baby from afar.
You would never
have to see him. You have that motherfucker, bitches in you. So I'm with you every day, and that motherfucker right there. And 9 times out of 10, once you have it, that baby not going with his daddy. It's staying with your ass.
Yeah.
So that baby with you is with me. So now I get to see it every fucking day. So I hate to make it seem like it's sexist, but in real life, though, I can go out, step out, have a kid. You never have to deal with that motherfucker. I can pay child support. I can go see my kid. I can spend time with my kid, and I never have to bring him home. But your shit gonna always be at the crib, and I'm gonna always be reminded of that bullshit that you did to me.
Yeah.
And I'm not trying to take nothing away from, you know, dude cheating on his woman or his woman cheating on a dude. I'm not saying it's no different, but the reality of it is when you have to look at that shit every day, it's a constant reminder. So it's
and all of my
that's what the fuck you up
to. Fuck you up too, like the box of honeycomb in the jar, big ass jar of pickles. Like, bitch, I went to get all these pickles and honeycomb and they don't have any. I'm fucked up.
You're speaking of the poor
John Pickles.
There it goes. What you say, bro? You say it's no can do?
Not gonna be able to
do it. Big win, what you say?
Gotta forgive and forget, man.
Yeah.
Gotta forgive and forget, man.
But stay with him, or?
Stay with her.
Stay with her?
Stay with her, man.
What?
No, hell no.
I was gonna say,
you still.
I was gonna say, you lie like hell. I'm about to say, any cookie.
You better drop it down the drain like a Ninja Turtle.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
Oh, no, he didn't say
like a Ninja Turtle.
Yeah, I shit gonna get banned after he says shit like that. I guess we can say that we are pro-abortion.
He's a guest, you know.
Right. We're pro-choice. Black Casper, man, what you think?
I mean, me personally, I probably couldn't do it because it's like, I don't know. I couldn't do that. That's a different responsibility. I don't even have to take upon, but I am.
Right.
Because if I'm living with it, because me as a person, if a kid is wrong, I ain't gonna treat him like
black.
I ain't gonna neglect him never. I'm just the kid, but sure. I mean, like,
for
but he's like part
of your responsibility where it ain't, like, it ain't gotta be.
I mean, if the dude ain't around, like, period or whatever. I mean, I don't know.
Yeah.
I couldn't do it.
Yeah.
No, I couldn't do it. The next person can look by that and look like, all right, it's just the kid and not the dude.
Not the dude, yeah.
You're in the picture, and you see, like, the kid need that father figure, you know what I'm saying? He is her boyfriend or her husband or whatever. So, I mean, it wouldn't hurt to take that responsibility. If the dude not around, like, at all, or died, or, like, crazy stuff like that.
They died. Like, you know what I'm saying? Dead,
like, trying to cushion the blow right there, man.
Hey, baby, dead or not, she still fucking, though.
Yeah,
so it's still going to be hard to.
It's an awkward situation all the way around.
All the way around.
That's an awkward situation, man.
Hey, Slim, what'd you say, man? It is what it is.
You know, my cousin probably be hurt. I'm gonna leave, but I'm still gonna keep
No, famous words. I quote, quote of the day, though. Slim say, I'm going to leave, but I'm still going to keep her. My money, what you say, bro?
Man, I can't fuck with her, bro. I'm
can't fuck with her, period. No, it's a wrap all the way together.
Please, wow, I'm slow, yo. Man, I
can't do it, dog. Yeah.
Chris Brown. Seeing this bitch
getting
pregnant, seeing her go through a whole 9 months, and then
seeing right, can you imagine though?
You
sitting there with
her. You gotta be by her side
because
you are.
You're her husband. Yeah, or some other, whatever. He still is, though.
You never know, man. Stands
up
where you stay, you know what I mean?
Like,
y'all got a lease, and y'all got a house.
You said
you got
a lease.
Yeah, lease. Hell, mortgage.
Hey, no, I know about that lease. You got to stay in them would be miserable
the
whole
time. Hell,
but not
hell.
That part, though.
Hell, no, I'm going to my mama house, bitch. I hate mortgage. I'm going to my mama. I ain't got to pay no bills until this mortgage shit over with. I'm going to my mama house, bitch. And I'll see you when I see you. I'll play that one with my part. After this shit over with, you better not even say my name, bitch.
Don't even say your name, period.
Damn.
And
they gonna be having free balls.
Free balls out. What the fuck you talking about, though?
What the fuck you talking about?
They said,
no. But, no, straight up, though. Fuck. Like, I can't do it. I'm proud to be living with that person that fucked up me at the same time. I ain't got to think
about it. I'm just getting angry thinking about it. Like, come on, man. Get to me.
Man, I'm just telling. I'm just saying this because, especially, I think it's a little different when you marry.
Racial barriers too. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
You know, you ask him what the fuck, he gonna be the same way? But
no.
You know, right. That's some shit, man.
Mm. You ain't doing it. All right, well, on me, man. I'm gonna go ahead and close it out, man. I definitely agree, though. I can't do it, and I think that. I know that it is a sexist opinion because so many women, so many wives have stayed with their dude after they had a kid outside the marriage or, you know, a relationship. But I think it's because of that one simple fact, dog, that you don't really have to deal with that situation. If you decide that, you know what, hey, I'm gonna fuck with him, I'm gonna stay with him for the kids or whatever, you don't ever really have to directly deal with that kid that he created. On the flip side of that, though, as a dude, you gonna always have to see this kid because this kid's gonna be with their mama. Like, it's gonna happen. Like, it's just a natural thing. So it's kind of a bold thing, but you can never get away from it. So even if you're trying to forgive and forget, it's gonna be a constant reminder, right, dog. And I think that's what does it. So on that tip, nigga, hell no. And whoever posted that shit that I reposted on Facebook, dog, I say that a real man would stay with his woman after she have a kid with side chick. I mean, with side dude, whoever posted that had to be a woman that posted that, first of all. I think that make you a real man. You may have made a real tough decision. I don't think that dictates whether you're a real man or not. I can't really say that. I can say you made a real decision.
Suck ass,
still made that decision, yeah. So, I don't know. But that's a whole other situation, man. But on that tip, dog, we up out of here, man. I want to thank everybody that checks us out today, man. Everybody that checks us out on eblockradio.com. The whole studio audience, all the people in the studio, man. Got my man City Shine in the building.
What up?
Got my man Big Win in the building.
Yo.
You know, I say got Black Casper.
Here, I'm there.
Got my man Sim in the building.
The Chief of the Keep.
Got my man Buck Woody.
Uh-huh.
And of course, man, your boy, the Hood, Howard Stern, holding down to the place to be, man. Shout out to my nigga Buzz, man. Rest in peace. Got a little bro at the end of the show tonight, man. Writers Block G, BMB, you know what I'm saying? BMB Records, dog. Get the money, dog. We out here, dog.
You don't ask me. What? Get the money.
get the money, get the money, my nigga. Get the money, my nigga, get the money. When you start lagging up, everybody say you funny. Fuck you a being, nigga, if it don't make sense. I can see through your shade, x-rays on the tent. Legs ain't fucked up, but walk with a limp. Cause these damn truths hold about a 10 strip. And if it ain't a 10, then it's probably about a 5. And if it ain't a 5, time to get a 9 to 5. Cause I need bitches, presents, money, money, moolah, bitch, yes. Marshawn Lynch on the bitch, use one word to answer your questions. It's in my DNA, I gotta get it. Cause I ain't having when to worry about the pissing. If you don't work, you don't eat. If you don't fuck, you don't sleep. If you woke up to play, shoulda kept your ass sleep. Let me get it on the good foot. Mr. Brown, P.O.P. with my hustle, nigga, hold it down. Tryna get the king, then it's bitch for the crown. If I ain't sipping white, then it's act of Georgia Brown. I'ma keep it real all the time, 100. You got weed, I got rubber, let's blunt it. You got hustle, I got hustle, let's bubble. You got hoes, I got hoes, let's fuck em. Every day I wake up, I gotta get the money, I gotta get the money. What I'm thinking about before I go to sleep, it's how to get the money, it's how to get the money. Get the money, get the money, get the money. Get the money, get the money, get the money. Get the money, get the money, get the money. Get the money, my nigga, 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 get the money.
Gotta get it.
Get the money, get the money, get the money.
B&B.
Get the money, my nigga, get the money.
What up, G?
Get the money, my nigga.
Let's get this money, nigga.
Get the money, get the money, get the money, my nigga.
Yeah, just count it up, bitch, I feel it myself. Dead fresh like I'm killing myself. Fuck asking, I get it myself. And if anybody asks you, I did it myself. Heard you niggas mad at my progress. But to make it where I'm at, it's a process. You only dish out what you digest. OG put that on my conscience. And ever since I heard that, a nigga been at it. Addicted to the shit, cause a nigga gotta have it. Money on the way, yeah, nigga gotta have it. Working like a fool, cause I'm sick of living average. Fuck fitting in, I'ma stand out. With luck, it was planned out. And all these niggas got a handout. Fuck with y'all niggas when the money ran out, huh?
Every day I wake up, I gotta get the money, I gotta get the money. What I'm thinking about before I go to sleep, it's how to get the money, it's how to get the money. Get the money, get the money, get the money. Get the money, get the money, get the money. Get the money, my nigga, 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 get the money. Get the money, get the money, get the money. Get the money, my nigga, get the money. Get the money, my nigga, get the money. Get the money, get the money, get the money, my nigga, get the money.
Sprint presents Lie Detector. Kyle and Audrey have been hooked up to a lie detector. Let's see who's telling the truth and who's lying.
I have iPhone Forever from Sprint, so I never have to wait to get the newest iPhone.
I don't have iPhone Forever from Sprint, so it's 15 months until I can upgrade to the new iPhone 6S. But I don't mind waiting. And I'm not jealous of your new iPhone either. Honestly, I'm not lying.
Get the fire extinguisher!
On second thought, can I just switch to Sprint?
The world's best offer on iPhone 6S. Get iPhone 6S as low as $1 a month when you trade in your iPhone 6. And with iPhone Forever, get a new iPhone every year forever.
Offer not available everywhere. Includes 21-month lease, no security deposit. Excludes taxes, subject to well-qualified credit. New line port at $36 activation fee. Requires smartphone trade-in. Regular $22 a month. iPhone Forever's lease upgrade eligibility does not guarantee monthly payment amount, phone selection, or plan rates. Service is additional charge. Remaining lease payments due if service canceled. Restrictions apply. See Sprint.com.